Hello friends, thanks for checking my channel once again and I hope you're all doing great. I made this video today because I realized when I was explaining about how to implement security, that is SSL and SASL security inside your Kafka cluster in the last two videos of this series, I forgot to explain a very important Kafka tool called Kafka Consumer Groups. So today we are going to see what is Kafka Consumer Groups and how we can use it. So basically, you can find the Kafka consumer groups inside your Kafka installation under the bin directory. So you could see Kafka consumer groups shell script. So why we need this Kafka consumer groups utility? If you remember the second part of this Kafka series, where I explained how to launch a simple Kafka cluster without any security, you could remember I also explained about a utility called Kafka run class. So this Kafka run class can be used for several purposes. And one of the purpose is to monitor your consumer group. So for that, you need to execute this Kafka run class utility and pass the consumer group command interface, which is an admin client interface. And then for this interface, we need to pass certain parameters like the broker addresses, because this Kafka run class is a Kafka client. So we need to pass the broker addresses and not the zookeeper address. And then your Kafka consumer group and also a parameter called describe. So this will display output which shows your Kafka consumer groups and the list of topics for which your Kafka consumer group has subscribed, and then the list of partitions available under this topic, and also some offset information being consumed by your consumer group, and also some information about the lag, that is the number of consumers, number of offsets your consumer group has been lagging behind the current offset. And also it shows all the available consumers inside your consumer group. However, if you execute this Kafka run class as it is, when your Kafka cluster is implemented using security like SSL or SASL, then this command will fail. Let me show you with an example. I have a 3-node Kafka cluster running inside my local machine. I have three brokers, 0, 1, and 2. So my Kafka brokers are implemented, launched using SASL underscore SSL security, whereas my zookeeper is configured using two-way SSL. So now I'm going to start a simple Kafka console producer application. My console producer is going to produce to this topic called SSL topic, and the producer's properties are mentioned inside the producer.properties file. I explained about all these things in the previous parts of the Kafka series. So please check those videos because I'm not going to explain these things again here. So I'm going to execute this producer application. So my producer application has started. So let me send a message. Hi. Similarly, I'm going to start a simple Kafka console consumer application and going to consume those messages. So my Kafka console consumer is going to consume to this topic called SSL topic, and the properties files are mentioned in this file called, the properties are mentioned in this file called consumer properties, and I'm going to consume from the beginning. So now we have the message. Okay, so let me send one more messages. One more message, Kafka. So we have Kafka, perfect. So now my producer and consumer applications are running. These producers and consumers have already been producing and subscribing from this topic. So it is starting to consume from the point where it left, okay? So now what I'm going to do is, I'm going to execute this Kafka run class utility. So I'm just going to copy this command from my GitHub repository. You can also check my GitHub repository where I used to place all the config files as well as all the commands that I am using for my videos. So I'm going to execute this Kafka run class utility here. So I need to change my consumer group name. So what is my consumer group name? So my consumer is running using this consumer properties file, right? So if I open this property file, I can see my consumer group name as SASL underscore SSL. So I need to give this consumer group name here, SASL consumer describe. So you can see my consumer is, this command is failing with an issue called Java heap space. However, this particular issue, Java heap space, has nothing to do with the actual issue that we are facing. I already double checked it. This issue is basically happening because we are trying to execute this Kafka run class utility without any security. Because if you see this command is connecting to the brokers, but our brokers are configured using SSL, right? I mean SASL underscore SSL, right? So, but we are executing this utility without providing any kind of security configurations. So that's the reason it's failing. So for this purpose, we are going to use this utility called Kafka consumer groups sh. So if you open this shell script, this is basically the same thing, Kafka run class, okay? So, but they just wrapped it and placed under a separate shell script. So we are just going to use this Kafka consumer groups now. If you are going to execute this Kafka consumer groups without passing any security related parameters, then we are going to face the same issue that we faced with Kafka run class just now, because this Kafka consumer group, as I said, is just the Kafka run class executed with consumer group command interface. So we need to pass certain security related parameters, just like we passed certain parameters for our consumers and producers, okay? So I already created a property file for this purpose called consumer group client properties. So you could see this file contains all the properties required to execute Kafka consumer groups.sh in a secured mode. So you need to pass these parameters, which is security.protocol. So for security.protocol, we need to give SASL underscore SSL. In case if your Kafka brokers are configured using two-way SSL, then you need to give SSL. And then we need to pass the SSL protocol, and then we need to provide two more parameters related to trust store. So for trust store location, I already created a trust store file for this client, which is kafka.consumergroupclient.truststore.jks. I already explained about how to create these files in the part 4 of the Kafka series, so I'm not going to repeat those steps here. In case if your Kafka brokers are configured using just with the two-way SSL, then you need to provide three more parameters like ssl.keystore.location and then ssl.keystore.password and then ssl.key.password. So these three parameters are needed if your brokers are configured with two-way SSL. Since our brokers are configured with one-way SSL with SASL, we can skip these parameters. We can just stick with trust store parameters. And then we need to provide two more parameters related to SASL. So what is the SASL mechanism that we are going to use? So our brokers are being implemented with Scram SHA 512. So I'm going to use the same mechanism. And then we need to create pass the credential for connecting to the brokers. So I already created a credential called monitoring consumer, and also provided its password here. In case if you don't know about how to create these credentials, then please watch the previous part of the Kafka series where I explained about how to create SASL credentials. Finally, for this user monitoring consumer to be able to read information about the consumer group, SASL consumer, and also the offset information from the topics for which this consumer group has subscribed to, we need to create certain access control list for this user. Okay, I've already created these things, so let me show you all the ACLs associated with this monitoring consumer. So you can see this monitoring consumer has read access on the consumer group, SASL consumer, and also it has two more accesses, read and describe, on the topic, because this consumer group is currently subscribing only to this topic, SSL topic, right? So we need to create these ACLs for this user in order for this user to be able to use this Kafka consumer group shell script. In case if you don't know about Kafka ACLs, then please check the last part of the series because I explained about this thing also there. So now I think everything is ready and we are set. So let us now try executing this Kafka consumer group shell script. Let me open a separate console. So for executing this tool, you need to mention its name, Kafka consumer groups.sh, and then you need to pass the broker address, because this is a Kafka tool, right? Kafka client, right? So we need to pass the broker address, so bootstrap server. So for Bootstrap server, always pass at least more than one broker. So localhost 9092 and one more broker which is running on localhost 9093. Sorry. And then we need to pass a parameter called command config. And for this, this parameter is needed if your brokers are configured in a secured way, like SSL or SASL. So for this, we need to pass the property file that we just created, which is consumer group client.properties. And then we are going to monitor, first let us check what are the available consumers, consumer groups inside our Kafka. So for this, we need to provide a parameter called list. So you can see we have one consumer called SASL consumer running inside our Kafka cluster. Also, you could see some warnings being shown here, like SSL trust store location was supplied but is not a known config. However, I found these warnings as useless because, for example, it shows this parameter is not being used, right? But in case if I try to remove this parameter and then execute this Kafka consumer groups, then this application will fail. So basically, I found all these warnings as useless. So we can just ignore this. I'm currently using Kafka version 2.5. I hope this warnings must have been suppressed in Kafka 2.7, but I'm still not sure about that. You have to check it. So in case if you want to disable these warnings, then you can simply do this by going inside this config folder. So you can see something like tools log4j properties, right? So you have this warn being enabled, so just replace it by off. So if I execute this command again, then now you don't have any warnings. Okay, so that's how you can just suppress all those warnings. And one more thing, as I said, this Kafka consumer groups is just like Kafka run class being executed with Kafka admin command, right? So let me try to execute the same command. So I'm just going to execute the same command just with this property file. You will get the same result because both are same, right? But not the describe, because we are going to list the consumer groups, right? So just list, and also let me remove this thing. So you see, we get the same result, SASL consumer. So you can use either like this, or simply you can just use the Kafka consumer groups. So I prefer the first one. So now we executed this list. In case if you want to monitor your consumer group or describe about the consumer group, then just do this thing, and then to describe, and then so your consumer group name. Okay. So now you can see your consumer group name, the topics being subscribed by this consumer group, and the offset information being consumed, and also the lag information, and also the individual consumers inside this consumer group. So you can just use this thing. So we can just, we can now see all the interesting parameters for this utility. Okay. So if you want to see all the members of this consumer group, then you can just do a consumer group and then members. So now you can see this consumer group as one consumer, okay, and which is running on this localhost machine. Now let me try to start one more consumer for this consumer group. So I have one consumer already running. So let me, start one more consumer. Okay, so I'm going to start one more consumer consuming from the same topic, okay, using the same property file, which means this consumer is also going to use the same consumer group. So I start one more consumer. So let me try to produce two messages now. Okay. So you can see one message is being consumed by this consumer and one message is being consumed by the new consumer that we started. Okay, so let me execute this command again. Now hopefully this should show two consumers. You see, so this group now is having two consumers with two different consumer IDs. Okay, so because we start one more consumer, right? So if you want to see even more rigid informations, you can just pass a parameter called verbose. Okay, so let me try to do some grep. Okay, so verbose. So you can see some rigid information with something called assignment. So you can see this consumer is assigned to consume from the topic from this topic and from the partition 0, whereas this second consumer is going to consume from this partition 1, because this topic has two partitions. So now each of these consumer is going to, has been assigned one partition, and they are going to consume from the respective partitions being assigned. So we also have some interesting parameters. So if you want to see something like state of this consumer group, so you can see this consumer group is stable and running, and it has two members. Okay, and the consumers are assigned using the assignment strategy called range. So there are different set of assignment strategies like range, round robin. I'm not going to explain about these things now. However, in future I'm going to definitely make a separate video and going to explain about all these things like assignment strategies, partition leader elections, and so on. Okay, and we can see this coordinator as localhost 9092, which is broker 0, is running there. So coordinator, what is actually a consumer group coordinator? So consumer group coordinator is the one that actually is actually a broker that actually receives the request from individual consumers to join a consumer group. So now we started one new consumer here, right? So this consumer first sends a request to this broker, okay, which is acting as the consumer group coordinator, and this consumer group coordinator accepts this consumer's request and joins this consumer to this consumer group. Similarly, this consumer group coordinator is also it will also receive requests from the consumers for reading messages, okay, from the partitions. So this is the role of the consumer group coordinator. Normally this consumer group coordinator must be equivalent to the controller, controller of the Kafka cluster. Okay, in most of the cases it should be the same, but sometimes it can also be different. So we execute this state. So now let me show you one more interesting parameter called related to offsets. So you have your consumer group running, right? So let us check what is the offset information being consumed. So you can see your consumer group is up to date. So on partition 0 there are 11 offsets and all the 11 messages are being consumed, and on partition 1 there are 9 messages and all the 9 messages are being consumed. Okay, so in case if you want to skip some messages, okay, due to some issues, then you can use a parameter called reset offset, something like this. So but for using this parameter, you need to first stop your consumers. Okay, so you need to make sure that your consumers are inactive. So let me stop all my consumers. So let me produce some messages. Computer, for example, okay. Laptop, something like this. Okay, so now if I execute this command, so you can see now your consumer group is lagging behind two offsets, one on partition 0 and the other one on partition 1. So if you want to skip consuming this message, then as I said, first you need to stop your consumers, okay, and then you need to execute the parameter that I'm going to show you now. So you need to pass the same same command with some parameters, so which is reset offsets. Then you need to mention the topic for which you need to reset the offset. So because a consumer group can subscribe to several topics. So now we have this one topic. So let me pass this topic name, SSL topic. And then for resetting the offsets, there are several options. So let us try to, you know, like skip the latest message. Okay. So then we need to pass this parameter called to latest. Okay. So let me first try to, you know, like see how the information will be after executing this command. So for this purpose, you can just pass a parameter called dry run. Okay. So we can just execute that and dry run. Oops, sorry. I think there is some issue. Okay, I think we need to skip this parameter called describe. Okay. So we need to remove this describe because we are not going to describe this consumer group anymore, right? So let me remove this parameter. So now you see, if I'm going to execute this command, then after executing, the latest offset on partition 0 will be 12 and on partition 1 will be 11. Okay, which is basically, for example, you see the latest offset is actually, I mean the current offset is 11 and 9. In case if you execute this command, then after the execution, your current offset will be 12 and 10, which means this latest message, that is the one message has been lagging, right? This message will be skipped. So let us execute now. Okay. Remember, we just made a dry run. We didn't execute here. So if you want to execute, you need to, provide this command called execute. So we have executed it. Let us try to, execute this command again. So you see, this message has been skipped. So now all the current offset and the log end offset is the same. Okay. So this is how we skip the offset. So there are several options. Okay. So we can reset the offset either to the latest or to a specific time. Okay. Or even by offset number. Okay. So we can just, you know, like there is something like to offset. Okay. So we can just, you know, like specify some integer value, for example, specifically like 12 or something like this. Okay. Okay. So in case, let me provide, produce one more message. Okay. So now if you see, we are lagging by one message, right? On partition one. So if, this command, okay, this command is going to, reset to the latest one, but we didn't specify on which partition level. We specified on the topic level. So if you want to execute this command on the partition level, then all you need to do is you need to, you know, like specify the partition by like partition number like this: topic colon and partition name. So let me execute this command now. So you can see this partition 0 is committed to the latest offset. Okay. So now let us try to run this command showing the offsets being consumed. Okay. Sorry. We had the lag on partition 1, not on partition 0. So for this, all you need to do is 1. And of course, you don't have to do the dry run. You are going to execute this, right? So let me execute this. Perfect. So let me show this consumer group again. So now you see this partition 1 has been consumed. So this is how you can just do this on the partition level. Perfect. So this is all about Kafka consumer groups that I wanted to share with you briefly. Before winding up the video, let me share with you one more important information. So this Kafka run class, you know, it can also be used to find the latest offset on a partition level for a topic. So for this purpose, you need to execute this Kafka run class passed with this get offset shell interface and these parameters. So I took a screenshot from one of my earlier videos. However, this get offset shell interface can be used only when your Kafka brokers are not configured with any kinds of security like SSL or SASL, basically a plain text mechanism. But if your Kafka brokers are configured with security, then you cannot use this get offset shell interface. So currently a work is going on to overcome this issue. So you can just go to KIP635. So you can see this get offsets shell, some improvements have been proposed. So one of the improvements is this thing. So currently it is impossible to use this tool with secure configurations, okay? So what will be the future is there will be a new shell script, get Kafka get offsets, just like Kafka consumer groups. We will be having one more shell tool called Kafka get offsets. And this tool will be the one to overcome this issue. With get offsets, with get offset shell. Okay, so if you go to this Jira, you can already see some patches available. So if you want to have a look into this patch, you can just scroll down to this Jira, and then you can see the patch being available here. Okay, so you can see this is the patch available for Kafka get offsets. However, I have never tested this patch, and also. This is still not available under production, okay? So we have to wait for it. I already checked the bin directory. I also checked for the Kafka 2.7 version. Still, it's not available. So we have to wait for it. However, in case if you know how to find the latest offset on a partition level for a topic without using get offset shell, then please do mention in the comment section, because I don't think we have any other way to find this information. However, I'm not sure. So if you have any information, please share in the comment section. So this is all about today's video. In case if you have any questions or if you have any doubts, please do mention in the comment section. Also, you can send me a private message to my Twitter, because I'll be active there always. So I could promptly respond to your questions. So thank you once again for watching this video. Until next video, I wish you once again great luck in your Kafka journey. And also, I wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. See you guys.